presented by Ontario, Canada, in partnership with Destination Ontario, Strike King Lure Company, St. Croix Rods.
Hey, back up to Northern Ontario, fishing for walleyes and a brand new adventure. Moosehorn Lodge in Chapleau, Ontario. The walleyes up in this area here offer so much opportunity. You know why? Because it's not just one lake. And this lodge has been around since 1957. Am I excited about fishing here? You bet I am. Now, anytime you're fishing a new lake, whether it be with a guide at a lodge, the lodge owner, or even by yourself, take a little bit of effort and figure out the depth you're going to fishing, the water clarity. Is it going to be rocks? Is it going to be weed and wood? At every lodge you go to, regardless of what you're fishing for, especially walleyes, you know, accept all the knowledge the lodge owner is going to give you. It is paramount. It'll help you so much to find fish quickly. Now, you know how walleyes are. It's not right away drop and catch. When you find them, it can be like that. But walleyes, half the fun is figuring them out, finding them, then catching them.
There we go. And doesn't feel bad either, duck. It's fighting like a walleye. Slow head shakes. Look at that. I think it's got some size too. Look at that. Oh yeah. Nice little, if we're eating, that'd be eating size, wouldn't it?
Yeah, that would be.
My first moose horn walleye with Doug. Right on, man.
Put your fingers.
Yeah. Just popped it nice too.
Yep.
So we just let the fish go today, right?
Yep.
Yeah. So that's about the eating size you want people to take right there, right?
Right.
Yeah. And what do you allow? Four a day?
Four a day, and one over 18.
Okay. But you encourage them more to keep the 14, 15s, right?
Yes, and let the bigger ones go.
Yeah,
that's
for sure.
That's your breeding population.
Yeah, man. It's all about the adventure here, right?
Yeah.
You know, coming to a nice lodge and enjoying these lakes. And you said you've got over 12 lakes you can go to. Anyone
yes.
you want to pick, right?
Yes.
Right on. Looking forward to it. Well, I broke the ice officially.
You talk about exciting. You know, a lake I've never been on in my whole life. So Doug says, what do you want to fish for? Some numbers or size and stuff? Hey, I just want to catch some walleyes. This is a treat for me too. So we get out to the first area and I see he's got that big 3-8 ounce with the white curly tail grub. You know, real obnoxious, but that's what walleyes want sometime.
All right, time to catch some fish right here. Two jigs right below the boat. Doug's going with the minnow. I'm gonna try the good old earthworm.
There we go.
And Doug's on another one. He's taking some line. Netting fish?
Yeah, maybe.
No, just that's a nice walleye too. Look at that. Wow. Doug will give you a hand. Oh, you got it. Okay. Yeah, there's probably a 16, 15 plus. Those are nice, man. Wow.
Doug, with the 3-8 ounce, bouncing almost right below the boat, starts catching fish. I pick up real quick on what do I gotta do? Do I gotta use the 3-8 ounce, stay with a quarter, or let out a bit more line to make sure that I'm bouncing bottom where those walleyes are off this point?
Oh, I got one.
You got one?
Yeah.
Are you sized to it?
It's pretty nice.
Well, look at that. I'm fixing up another good eater size. Same spot, Doug. We're pretty close, huh?
15 inches.
15.
15 and a half.
Yeah, man.
There we go.
Nice stuff, for sure.
You talk about fun. There's nothing like finding walleyes. You're fishing around, you're doing everything right, jigging, your focus and concentration, it's peaked. You're like a cat, first thing in the morning, jigging slow, all of a sudden there's that mushiness. When you set, and it's just a slow little head shake, you know walleyes are in the boat.
Just incredible how many walleyes you have here, Doug.
Yeah, you took that one down pretty good.
Yeah. Look at that. Oh, yeah. He's the one who's like, come on, put your finger down there. No,
get
thanks.
Pliers?
Yeah, I got one here, okay. Thanks.
I'll stick my fingers in there.
Look at that, man. I go all over Ontario for walleyes like that. That's the size right there you want. Look at it. That's a handful. Like those, a couple big fillets in there. Yeah. You know, I don't know if you can eat more than two walleyes a day. Hey,
that's,
like,
yeah,
that's four fillets.
Yeah.
Yeah. Go on, fish. It's giving me a thrill, man. Wow. Nothing like catching eating-sized walleye. But on this trip, I wanted to come just to hopefully show you, to inspire you, that right here in Chapleau, Moosehorn Lodge is the place to go. Why? Because they have opportunities of different lakes, lots of different lakes to fish. It's an adventure. But you might have the whole lake all to yourself.
Oh, I got...
You got a fish too.
Yeah, I got
it
a fish.
It just doesn't stop. You need me to help you with the net?
I might need the net for this.
Okay? Sure. Put that there.
This feels like a... Oh, it's a little bit smaller.
Oh. Okay, well, get some release. I feel like a kid in a candy store. Something about jigging down, dropping down, tick, missing fish, hitting fish. It doesn't matter. It's the excitement. And that's why I love coming to Northern Ontario and the lodges. It's the excitement of figuring it out.
Uh-oh, I might have a nicer one on that. Well, that's just, man. Ooh, look at the big pike beside it. Oh, wow. There's a huge pike beside it. There he is, Ducky. Look at, he's hitting them. Wow. That was a big pike. He actually tried to grab it too, and I was lifting him out of the water. You okay, walleye? I saw that big pike. Oh boy.
Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? Hey? That's the closest to walleye I'm gonna taste this morning.
Go on. He's like, no, don't throw me back. That was a big northern. He was like this thick, Doug.
Yeah,
like
oh
that.
Yeah.
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 You think one of us are gonna hit him? Probably. Go away, pike. You got one there? He's got some green too. Yeah, look at, he's got blue on him too. Yeah. Looks like he's got a little bit of blue on there. Hard to tell. Man, they're beautiful fish here.
They're nice and clean, this one.
Yeah, they ever clean. Just missed one there. Wow, man. Two spots all morning.
Doug got us right on the edge of that point. We came out a little bit, wherever the fish are moving. And they do move a bit, chasing bait, but there was a little bit of weed and rock. You got stuck up a few times on bottom, but then you know your jig's in the right spot. But I mean, every time you're in the right spot, I can't tell you how many times we just drop down as the jig is falling.
Man, oh man. Just beautiful walleyes, and they're so healthy here, Doug. Right through the snodge, he was not going off. Got you through the nose, eh, boy? You're all warm. I know, I'll let you go. Go on. I'm looking for your grandmother or mother. We're almost getting ready for lunch, too. Breakfast and lunch. Oh, goodness. Fish are wild here, man. Wild.
We're hungry.
I'd say. Good thing that storm came last night.
Yeah.
Maybe they just decided not to eat during the storm. They said, hey. Wow. What a fishery. If you guys watching this aren't convinced yet, you will not be convinced because this is incredible. My worm is like maybe a quarter of an inch for taste. Straight down, below the boat, vertical jigging. And man, catching walleye after walleye after walleye. Oh, wow. Nice, decent fish too.
Where else on earth do you think you can find that up other than Northern Ontario, lakes all to yourself, you and your buddies, you and your family come on up here and fish, but you virtually have all this opportunity for yourself.
Oh. Unreal, man. How many walleyes are here? You weren't kidding when you said there's lots. Look how chunky these are, man. I'm impressed.
Oh, nice.
This
nice
is a great fish. Fishery. This is only one lake first morning. That's not too bad, eh? Good eaters, 14, 15 inch. I'm sold. moose horn. Let's get a few more and say lunch break.
So I have one.
Park right there.
Well, that's a nice one.
Nice walleye. Yep.
Uh-oh.
Catch and release again, huh?
Yep.
Wow. Non-stop. And there's another one. Guess who's right on the spot? Look at that, another nice one. Uh-oh, you know what? That's a real good one. Chunker.
Yeah.
Chunky walleyes. Yeah, that's nice. Wow. Gorgeous fish, Doug, man. Nice and thick.
It's so important when you're fishing walleyes to have craftsmanship and rods you can feel the bite. So you know the St. Croix Legend Tournament Walleye Series for me, or the Icon, you know, just something where I have the rod, it feels like an extension of my hand. In walleye fishing, nothing is more important than the sensitivity, because that bite sometimes just feels like a mush, a real light mush, almost like a leaf falling on your jig or your bait.
That might be it right there. He's got some beef to him. Let's see. Oh, he does too. Look at that, Doug. That is the one right there. Whoa. Okay.
All right, now we're gonna do that after dinner traditional evening walleye bite. Same lake, main lake, nope. Another brand new lake, potentially an opportunity to catch some bigger walleyes. And don't get me wrong, we filled the boat this morning. We only stopped because it was breakfast time. We ran out of bait. There's only two reasons you go back to the lodge early in the morning. Either the fishing is a bust or you run out of bait. We ran out of bait and still counted more than 40 fish that we caught, hooked, lost, you name it. But now is an opportunity to get out on a brand new lake, just us and the walleye.
Oh. You going there?
Yep, that's a good one.
All right, there's a good one.
That's a good one.
I like to hear that. I like hearing that.
The pike. Felt the head shaking.
Walleye.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it felt like a good one. I guess because of the wind.
Yeah.
Everything's pulling.
So you haven't caught one since this morning.
No.
That's why.
Yeah. Buddy.
Bye, walleye. Okay, now the wind's a bit more choppy out here in the small lake, okay? So I'm gonna go strictly to the 3/8 ounce with the bright green chartreuse and orange grub, tip it with a minnow, and just do that slow bouncing. I'm not gonna cast far, I'm gonna drop it almost beside the boat, let a little bit of line. Now the deal with the 3/8, when you're power drifting like that and jigging, you don't have to let as much line out with the 3/8 because it's a bit heavier jig. We're only fishing between 8 and 12 feet of water. There we go. Is that grass? I'll be embarrassed if that's grass. No, that's a walleye. Look at that. About the same size you got there. Catch and release, sir. That's about 15 and a half.
Yeah.
Eating size if we wanted to eat. But we were lucky enough that Roxanne made us ribs for dinner. Oh yeah, roll out the red carpet for us. Yeah, man. Golden walleye. See ya. Yeah, for dinner treat. Love it. So we get to the first point, get a couple small walleyes, and Doug suggests, let's go down further to the lake. I've got a rocky area that's real close. The wind's been pushing in. So when you come to these northern lodges too, take a look at what you're fishing on these very pristine lakes. But walleye still, they move. And try to position yourself where you think the bait might be. Back of a bay if the wind's pushing in. And right away, we hook in to bigger and beautiful golden walleyes. There we go. That's a good one. Yeah, that's a big fish. Oh, what are you, Ikey? Some big walleyes fight like that. He's staying down there. Oh, yeah, it's a good walleye.
Whoa.
Yeah. Here we go.
Whoa. The big one.
Yeah. Look how they fight, eh? Just like
Big pike or something, huh?
Yeah.
Wow, nice one, Doug.
Yeah.
Nice, look at the thickness of those fish. Jeez. Nice. Moose Horn Lodge, dudes. After dinner treat. Take them out of the net, take a few pictures, kiss them, release them.
Hey, some nice pictures. Let that beautiful walleye go.
Look how healthy, look.
It's gone. Evening, after dinner, nap, fantastic dinner. You name it, this is what lodges are all about. In Moose Horn up here in Chapleau, walleyes like that produce those kind of numbers you saw this morning, where it's like 40 fish in 2.5 hours. Let those bigger ones go, and you'll have those kind of numbers you had all day, but still come out after dinner and catch those big, beautiful walleyes in Northern Ontario.
Now the thing of coming Northern Ontario in these lodges, you know, we have regulations, and they're conservation-minded, especially these lodges, because you want these fisheries to be here for years to come, for generations to come, for your kids and their kids. So think about it. You know, you're allowed 4, keep maybe 2. You know, 3 under 14, 1 over 18, but that 1 over 18, take a picture, kiss it, keep it in the net, respect the fishery, and it will reward you with years and years of walleye fishing. So keep a couple if you want for shore lunch. You're here for a week, 10 days, 2 weeks. That's a lot of fantastic meals. But conserve, have fun, and this is about catching, laughing, and having a great time at the adventures of Moose Horn Lodge.
Hi, I'm Roxanne Lynn. I run Moose Horn Lodge in Chapleau with my husband, Doug. We've been in business since 1957. My parents started it way back then, and we're second generation. We have 6 housekeeping cottages. They're fully furnished. They come with fridge, stove, pots, pans, dishes, bedding, barbecue, all electric, satellite TV. We are open in the winter. We cater to sledders. We have a lot of lakes in the area that you can fish. Walleye, pike, brook trout, smallmouth bass. There's a lot of whitefish in a lot of the lakes. It's kind of an adventure tourism, really, an adventure lodge. You have to travel from lake to lake because we have so many lakes in the area, they don't get a lot of fishing pressure. So you might be the only boat on a lot of the lakes. It's kind of attractive for our guests. That's what they like to do. They like to be able to go to different lakes. They like to be able to be by themselves on a lake. We give them instructions when they come into the lodge, where to fish, when to fish, how to fish, what time of day to fish, what species. We give them maps of the different lakes that they can go to. We point out the fishing areas on all these lakes. And then we load a boat on a trailer for them and get them all equipped and rigged up and give them minnows and worms, because that comes with the package deal, which is the cottage, boat, motor, gas, and bait for the week, and send them off. And they'll come back and report in the evening to make sure that they've come back safely, and send them to a different lake the next day. We are a conservation-minded lodge. We know the regulations, you're allowed 1 over 18 for walleye, but we inform all of our guests when they check in that we would prefer that they would throw those walleye back, because that is the future of the fishery. As for pike, you can catch some nice, 40, 45, 50 inch pike. Same thing, you'll catch a lot of bass, smallmouth bass, but again, we ask, throw the bigger ones back, because if you want to come back here and if you want to have a fishery for the next 20, 25 years, 30 years, if you're looking for a lodge where you want a little bit of adventure, you're able to go to different lakes every day if you want, you'll have a great time.
What an adventure. Roxanne told me from the beginning, you're gonna have fun, but put a little bit of effort in if you wanna go yourself. I was fortunate to be able to fish with Doug, the lodge owner. Going there?
Yeah.
Decent size?
Yeah, feels like it, yeah. Oh yeah.
Nice, nice. Better put that rod down there, huh? That's what we like. Nice fighting walleyes. Oh, look at that, eh?
Gorgeous fish, wow.
They're down there.
Yeah, man, golden yellow here, aren't
yeah.
they? Gorgeous fish. Beautiful, man. This lake has beautiful walleyes. It's like a mud bottom. You think to yourself, no way, but it's almost like they swim with their bellies through the mud. They know how to eat, and that's what Moose Horn has. They have opportunity. So if you want numbers, you want to catch pike,
the smallmouth fishing, which I totally missed out on. So the walleyes were the deal.
There he is.
Yeah. That's another good one. Oh boy. Oh yeah, that is. It's a good walleye. Let's see. Or is that Ikey? Hard to tell. He's on the top for a sec there, Doug. Oh, it's a walleye.
Yeah.
Coming up.
There we go. That's
wow.
Nice.
Look at that. That might conclude our evening, huh? The jig just pop out?
Yep.
Let's show the folks at home how nice and beautiful these walleyes look. And an easy release for an evening of walleye after dinner. Wow, man. Moosehorn Lodge, Chapleau. You're convinced? Multiple, 30, 40 fish in the morning, after dinner. An hour go back, enjoy some camaraderie, talking, some pops, and just think about the fantastic day we experienced waiting right here for you at Moosehorn Lodge in Chapleau, Ontario. We'll see you next time on the Extreme Angler from somewhere in Ontario.
Extreme Angler has been presented by Ontario, Canada, in partnership with Destination Ontario, St. Croix Rods, Strike King Lure Company, Rage Tail Soft Baits, Gamma Fishing Lines, Power Pole. Visit us at fishextreme.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.